फ्लोरल कैरेक्टर्स। इन फ्लोरल कैरेक्टर्स फर्स्ट वन इज इनफ्लोरेसेंस। इनफ्लोरेसेंस, इनफ्लोरेसेंस इज जनरली साइमोस, साइमोस इनफ्लोरेसेंस। ऑफन सॉलिटरी, सॉलिटरी मीन्स सिंगल फ्लावर इज डेवलप्ड फ्रॉम द एक्सिल ऑफ द लीफ। फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस इज लीफ, फ्रॉम द एक्सिल ऑफ द लीफ सिंगल फ्लावर इज अराइज़्ड। Such flowers are called solitary flowers and axillary. They are developed in the axils. Sometimes cauliflowers in groups. Cauliflowers means leaves are flowers are directly developed on stem. Such condition is called cauliflowery. Have you understanding? What happens here in cauliflowery? Flowers are directly produced on stems. This condition is called cauliflowery. This is very important point in entrance point of view. Okay, next coming to flower. In the inflorescence, flowers are present. What is the condition of flowers? First, flowers are bracteate or ebracteate. You imagine that this is a flower. If flower contain bract, such flowers are called bracteate. If bract is absent, then that flower is called ebracteate. Next, this is pedicel. If the flower contain pedicel, such flower is called pedicellate. Next, actinomorphic. Actinomorphic means we can cut the flower into two equal halves in any plane. Such flowers are called actinomorphic flowers, but zygomorphic in monodora. In monodora, flowers are zygomorphic due to difference in size of petals. Next, flowers are hermaphrodite, that means bisexual. Flowers are bisexual, both stamens and gynoecium. Androecium and gynoecium are present in the same flower. Such flowers are called bisexual or hermaphrodite. Next, unisexual flowers are seen in Stelicocarpus. Stelicocarpus. And flowers are complete. Next, trimerous. Flowers are trimerous and hypogynous flowers. Perigynous flowers are seen in Eupomaceae. Eupomaceae. Okay. And flowers are spirocyclic, that means spirally arranged, spirally arranged. And flowers are aromatic, that means they release characteristic odor. This is about flower. Next, coming to floral parts. First part is the outermost whorl of flower is calyx. Outermost whorl of flower is calyx. Generally in the calyx, sepals are 3 in number. They are sepaloid polysepals, that means they are free. Sepals are free without fused. Next, aestivation is valvate. Valvate aestivation. You can also see that aestivation. These are sepal margins. They are not overlapping with each other. Such arrangement is called valvate aestivation. Okay, next, corolla. Petals are 6 in number. They are arranged in two whorls. Each whorl contain 3 petals. They are arranged in valvate aestivation. Okay, sometimes there is no differentiation between sepals and petals, then it is called perianth. Perianth means there is no differentiation of petals and sepals. This condition is also seen in some flowers or some species. Next, coming to androecium. Androecium stamens are generally numerous. They are numerous means number of stamens are present in the flower. Plenty or numerous. Next, they are arranged in spiral fashion. Spiral fashion means like this, spirally arranged. Stamens are arranged in spiral fashion and they are present on thalamus, lower side of the thalamus. This is thalamus. On the thalamus lower side, these stamens are arranged. Next, filaments are short. Stamens contain short filaments. Filaments are very short and they are adnate with anther. That means filaments are fused with anther and the connective shows overgrowth and that forms a hood-like structure. This is a hood-like structure, hood, that forms a hood-like structure over the anther. Next, stamens are dithecous. That means two lobes are present in the stamen. Such condition is called dithecous anthers. Next, anthers are long. They are long. This is about androecium. Next, coming to gynoecium. In the gynoecium, carpels are numerous. That means number of carpels are present. Usually they are free. Carpels are free. Next, they are arranged in spiral fashion and they are developed on receptacle. That means all the carpels are present on the receptacle. Apocarpus means they are free. All the carpels are free and superior ovary. Next, unilocular. Ovary is unilocular. In Monodora, syncarpus ovary with parietal placentation. In Monodora, syncarpus ovary is present. Generally, ovary is apocarpus. Apocarpus means all the carpels are free. But in Monodora, syncarpus ovary is present. That is the special character seen in Monodora. And placentation is parietal placentation. Parietal placentation means number of carpels are present. These carpels are fused on their margins. For example, this is one margin, this is one margin, this is another, this is another. Where the margins are fused, their placenta is developed. Such placentation is called parietal placentation. Okay. Once again, I am repeating. In parietal placentation, number of carpels are present. These carpels are fused on their margins. Where the margins are fused or united, their placenta is developed. On the placenta, ovules are present. Such placentation is called parietal placentation. Next, style is short, stigma is small. This is about style and stigma. Next, coming to fruit. Fruit is aggregate fruit, aggregate berries. All the number of carpels are present in the ovary. That's why they are developed into berries. These all are aggregated to form a fruit. That fruit is called aggregate fruit. Okay. Next, coming to seed. Seed is large, numerous and endospermic. Seeds are endospermic. Here one specific character is seen in the seeds of Annona squamosa. In Annona squamosa, seeds have endosperm. That endosperm shows ruminations. That means foldings, folded endosperms. Invaginated endosperm is found in Annona squamosa seeds. Such endosperm is called ruminate endosperm. Ruminate endosperm. Okay, are you understand? In the endosperms, ruminations or foldings are present. Such endosperm is called ruminate endosperm. Next, coming to pollination. Pollination is entomophilous. That means pollination takes place with the help of insects. Next, coming to floral formula. Floral formula. You can also see here in the floral diagram, the flower contain bract. Bract means BR. Next, bracteoles are absent. Bracteoles are indicated here. Here, no indicator of bracteoles, so that it is called EBRL. EBRL. Bracteate, ebracteolate. Next, this is actinomorphic. Actinomorphic flower. We can cut the flower into two equal halves in any plane. Next, bisexual. Both male female organs are present. That means stamens are present. Next, ovaries are present. That means androecium and gynoecium both are present in this flower, so that it is called bisexual. Next, K3. That means calyx contains sepals. Sepals are 3 in number. Count the sepals. 1, this is 2, this is 3. Total 3 sepals. They are free. That's why no bracket is kept around 3. Next one, corolla. Corolla 3 plus 3. 3 are present in outer oral and remaining 3 are present in inner wall. That's why it is indicated with 3 plus 3. 3 plus 3. And there is no bracket around 3 plus 3. Next, A. A means androecium. Number of stamens are present. That's why it is indicated with infinity. Next, gynoecium. Gynoecium contain number of carpels, so that it is also indicated with infinity. Ovary is superior ovary. That's why a line is kept below the G. This indicates superior ovary. This is about the description of Anonaceae family. Next,